I know.
True, I as a defense of refugee name, because a lot of people have different opinions about refugees. Some people hate refugee people, and some people don't like them, and some people think they are wrong, and some people they are enemies. And there is a lot of different opinions about refugees. I've been told, I've seen it, and I've had a conversation with people about it. As a defense, I want to say is, as a person that went through something like this to come to Australia and live in Australia, if I had no problem, and if I wouldn't have to, I wouldn't do it. You don't leave your family, you don't leave your friend, you don't leave your work, your love, your town, your land. You don't leave everything behind to go somewhere to be a refugee. You don't do that. You don't do that to yourself if you don't have to. You know what I mean?
Well, I've never heard this story. Like I,
A lot of people, they just
this this.
oh, this is the kind of thing, you're not gonna sit down and talk to everyone about this. You're not gonna just loudly tell everybody, "Hey, I was didn't I didn't
Well,
like
you know what
Muslims
they.
God, and I just came here. I said, fuck your Muhammad, and I came here, and I don't like your religion. I hate Muslims, and I came here." Nobody, you don't
No.
talk
Well,
about
people,
this to the public.
yeah. Well, they don't even, the papers don't sell that to us
They
anyway.
don't.
They just say, hey, we're Muslim. We're going to come to Australia. We, you know,
Exactly.
and we're going to get all the
Exactly.
benefits. That's what most people are led to believe
Yeah.
through the paper and stuff. That's why I stopped reading the paper and
Stop reading the paper
stopped
and
reading
watching
it.
your news, listen to the
Honestly,
podcast.
I feel great, man. Like we just spoke about before, it's been a year of not listening to any of that stuff, and my life is great. Here I am
Exactly, man.
talking to a guy.
A
I
lot
didn't
of
even have an opinion,
a
you
lot
know?
of a lot of things happening around the world that I don't need to know. But I need to know enough, and that's positive that I want to know. I want to know what I want to know.
Inspire and change people that you talk to every day.
Exactly. And you want to stay positive, you want to live life, and you want to listen to these. You want to listen to the normal life, and you want to see what's going on.
Well, man, honestly, someone's
Lovely
going to listen to
story, eh?
this.
Someone's going to listen to this. You know what happens? What happens is this is all goes for, like, this is hope. Like, I'm the person, I'm the twice dead person. So I'm sitting here in front of you, talking to you. I have nothing to lose right now because I was already dead. But I still have hope. I still work for like 6 days, and I still enjoy my life as much as I can because I love it. This is beautiful. Where we live, what we do, all we can travel.
And hey, and a message to other people. There's no need for you to worry about, you know what I mean? There's no need to worry about refugees at all. There isn't, because right now where we are, where are we, Burley? There's no problems.
The thing is, they're not worried about refugees to something happen to them. That's a, goes back to the financial problems. I realize because I am one of those people, like, because the Australian government has a lot of services and a lot of payments for the people that don't work. But they're not only refugees. If you realize, there's a lot of people that don't work and they get money from government. So what happens is, refugees, they come to Australia, they don't speak English, they can't do nothing, they don't want to do anything, they sit home, they get money from the government, and me and you have to pay for it. But like me, I start paying my own tax and everything first month when I came to Australia, because I wanted it today to be a good day for me. I wanted it today to have my own thing. People, some people, they want to live with little bit of money, live like shit. Let them leave.
I know a mate. I know
But
my next door
refugees
neighbor,
aren't
an Aussie guy who was a truck driver, but just gave it up, pretended he had a sore back, and he's on a disability pension. Like all these other guys that are just on a disability pension, they're just slugging through life, you
Yeah,
know.
but and also, but refugee is not a threat. Australia based on a refugee country. They built it, built like this.
Man, good
We're
story. Good story.
I know, man. I
Look,
know.
I don't have a
Long
story
time,
like
mate.
that. No, hey, I reckon we've come to an end. Seriously, That's the greatest thing
I've
ever heard.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
It was a good impression. And it was a good talk. I really enjoyed it. And
honestly, when's the last time we didn't look at our phones in 50 minutes?
That was 60 minutes ago.
And it's all about telling stories, and you did a good job. So yeah. I'm going to come get a haircut off you soon.
Yeah, definitely. Mm. Come up and we'll give you nice...
Razor cuts.
Razor King cuts.
The
king sitting here.
Yeah. That's really cool, man. And we met at Fight Like a Pro Boxing.
Fight Like a Pro was one of the best experiences in my life.
Yeah.
And I really enjoyed the time.
What made you go there?
What? I wanted to prove that I can stay against someone and hit them and not get caught.
Yeah.
That was... No, I'm joking, but...
Listen to me.
Yeah. No, I was only joking, but Fight Like a Pro was an experience that I have never done in my life. I've been doing a lot of sports like in my entire life, but the boxing was something that I never done, and I wanted to try it, to give it a go, see what I can do, and I was pretty good at it.
Yeah.
Pretty fast.
But for me, it changed my business life.
Did it?
Well, just a little bit, like... I've got a father with a big business.
Yeah.
I was starting to get all sorts of creeps coming my way, thinking that I personally had a lot of money and that I would easily give them $10,000 for some investment. And I was like, no, man, like, no, don't, you know. And then I had a couple sort of not recently sort of get a bit intimidating. Yeah. I thought, and it was more, and that's completely gone out of my mind now, you know. What having some sort of training and you know, fitness, all that sort of stuff has lined up for a great sort of business life, I've found. You know, more like, hey,
I reckon,
and mentally strong.
Exactly. I reckon it's, if you go ask all the people done the Fight Like a Pro, it's different opinions about everybody. Like, it depends what's in your head and why you do it, and then what is going on, and then what kind of reaction does in your life. So... Yeah. It was positive for me.
Yeah, massive.
It was positive. Yeah. Anything like that, at the end of the day, if I have no explanation what is happening or what is not, it was positive. That's all I can say.
Good on you, man.
Good on you, man.
I'm glad you came in. And
thanks for having me.
Welcome to episode number 53.
Yo.
See you around.